Good afternoon, parents, family, friends, faculty, Board of Education, and class of 2020. I want to first start by giving a thank you to our faculty, as through these unprecedented times, you have provided grace and empathy and always put our students at the heart of all you did. For that, I thank you. To the parents and guardians of our graduating seniors, words cannot express the appreciation and gratitude for your continued support and involvement here at Raymond Central. It is invaluable to have a cohesive bond amongst our staff, students, and families. Thank you for sharing your kids with us and for entrusting us with their educational and personal development. To the class of 2020, what a year it has been for the both of us. As I entered a year of many firsts, you entered a year of many lasts. We have endured many challenges and created many positive memories together. From cheering the Mustangs on in the stands, to arriving on each of your doorsteps to deliver your cap and gowns, and everything in between, are the memories that I will cherish as you are the first graduating class for me as principal. You are gifted and talented. As you enter a world much different than you expected, I hope you all know how much you are needed, now more than ever. My hope for you is that you always know all that you have to offer and you never let the fear of failing stop you from all that you can accomplish. In times like this, it is important to remember the words of poet John Greeley Whittier in his poem, Don't Quit. When things go wrong, as they sometimes will, when the road you're trudging seems all uphill, when the funds are low and the debts are high, and you want to smile, but you have to sigh, when care is pressing you down a bit, rest if you must, but don't you quit. Life is strange with its twists and turns, as every one of us sometimes learns. And many a failure comes about when he might have won had he stuck it out. Don't give up, though the pace seems slow. You may succeed with another blow. Success is failure turned inside out, the silver tint of the clouds of doubt. And you never can tell just how close you are. It may be near when it seems so far. So stick to the fight when your heart is hit. It's when things seem worst that you must not quit. This unprecedented time has equipped you with lessons and skills as you begin your next chapter. The flexibility, patience, empathy, grace, and most importantly, resiliency you have shown this year will help guide and shape the steps you take to achieve your goals and your dreams. Your next journey will take you all on different paths. Some of you are entering the military, some of you headed to college, and some of you headed into the workforce. Whatever journey you are about to begin, I hope you never forget where it all started. The memories you created, good and bad, have built the person you are today. Those same memories will act as guidance as you turn the page in life. I would like to sincerely wish the best of luck to each one of you on your future endeavors. Oh, and Mr. Walla, you may now use the vending machine.
Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to the day that some of us never thought would come, our graduation ceremony. On behalf of the class of 2020, we thank you for joining us to celebrate our last high school event. For the last 4 years, I've sat in the band, watching and waiting for the day that it would finally be our class's turn to walk across the stage. And that day has finally come. Class of 2020, we did it. We survived 13 years of school. Whether you started at Valparaiso or Ceresco or transferred in, we have ended up together today for this huge milestone in our lives. Surviving high school is a huge accomplishment, and we did it together. Granted, there have been good times and times where our teachers didn't think that some of us would ever graduate. As our time here together draws to a close, I would just like to prove to you how much we have grown. In junior high, we were the troublemakers, squirting each other with water bottles, messing around with our backpacks, and running through the halls to try to get to our next class. We are the reason that several new rules for the junior high have been put into place today. Sorry, junior high, we are the reason why you can't have Gatorade squirt bottles or backpacks. Oops. At that time in our lives, I remember sitting through lots of lectures from teachers saying that we need to grow up and act like young adults. Over the past 4 years of high school, I am proud to say that we have become good and mature people. After we leave here today, some of us will go off to college to become future nurses, business people, engineers, and counselors, while some of us will jump right in the workforce and become excellent welders, farmers, and managers, and some of us will become soldiers and protect our country. I don't know about you, but that sounds pretty grown up to me. Even though today might be the last day that some of us ever see each other, just remember that we went from impacting each other to impacting all of our future fields and relationships. As we leave here today, I encourage you to push yourself, whether if that is pushing to get another degree, expand a business, or just to get out of your comfort zone and try something new. I would like to thank all of the teachers, staff, administration, and anyone who has made an impact on our class today. Class of 2020, the future is ours and the future is us. Be amazing or be forgotten. Once again, I would like to welcome and thank you all for being here as we celebrate our graduation ceremony.
Remember all those times our parents told us to get off our phones, computers, or TVs because nothing ever good comes out of those things, or any inconvenience is always caused because we're on them too much? Well, I'd like to let them know that one of the most influential moments of our lives, our high school graduation, is happening virtually from these very TVs, phone screens, and computers that we happen to be on just too much. To my fellow classmates, this isn't how our year was supposed to end, this isn't how we're supposed to be graduating, and this isn't how life was supposed to play out. However, I want to congratulate each and every one of you for persevering and making it to this point. Some of us have been here since the jump, others since freshman year, and some have trickled in as the years move forward. However, we've each found a place at Raymond Central High School regardless of our backgrounds. As we venture into our new lives, we'll experience more diversity than we've ever seen. Many individuals won't look like you, share the same beliefs as you, or love like you. Many people won't fit your idealistic mold of how a person should pursue life, but these differences make us unique and keep the world interesting. These differences are what I believe have created such a close-knit class of 2020. As said by Stephen Covey, strength lies in our differences, not our similarities. This may lead some to believe that the class of 2020 was a bit too strong, which can easily be proven by the days spent in English 10 with one of RC's most memorable faculty members. 1 year with the class of 2020, and they took that as their calling to run for the hills. Although the class of 2020 may have been a handful, we have had plenty of positive moments over the years. The Friday night spent on the football field in some of the best student sections, having some of the best late night meals after games, and even CPR class with Mr. Spalla. Freshman year was a time when we all started to find ourselves. Quite an awkward time as we began to grow and tried our best to navigate the real high school experience. Everything began to get complicated. Grades started to count, and as hard as it is to fathom, some of our classmates began to date. Looking back at the amount of change our class has been through is quite impressive. The number of teachers and fellow classmates we've seen come and go over the years, and an entire administrative change. As we pushed into sophomore year, our class began to drive on the open road. It seemed as though we had more freedom than we had ever had, but we really didn't even know the half of it. As junior year quickly swept us off our feet, a majority of our class fell face first right into a pile of early onset senioritis. Considering the amount of tardies our class has ranked up over the years, can definitely provide evidence for that. But now we're here. We're done. The days of ACT testing and roaming the halls after finals are over. As said by Charles Dickens, it was the best of times, it was the worst of times. The world we live in is full of change, adversity, and danger. Not all of those are bad, but they can definitely tamper with one's plans. Each and every one of us had a plan for how we wanted our last year of high school to play out, to see our last prom, pull a senior prank, spend that last day with peers, classmates, and teachers, and even have a senior skip day, not necessarily a whole quarter. As upsetting and easy as it is to dwell on what could have been, we must look forward. There are those who have lost more than us. There are those who won't be able to bounce back from the effects of this troubling time. As we move forward into the workforce and immerse ourselves into a life of further education, I know that each and every one of us will yield great things. It is our newfound responsibility as young adults to help the world and those who need it most. We can't change the past, but we can make a change in the future. Our time in high school is over, but the memories we made will last forever. many of us can relate our experiences to the words of Ron Swanson. I regret nothing. The end.
Good afternoon, families, friends, teachers, administrators, and most importantly, my fellow graduates. It is an honor to speak on behalf of the class of 2020 as the valedictorian and class president. My class and I thank you all for taking time out of your day to honor our individual and class accomplishments. With that being said, I'm going to try and keep this as short as possible, just like our senior year. Many of us have been together since the very beginning, whether we went to the Ceresco or Valparaiso Elementary School. Some of us joined along the way, but now here we all finally are on our graduation day. Class of 2020, we finally did it. I never imagined that this is how our time together would end, but all of our hard work has finally paid off. During our time spent at an old military base, we have learned a lot. Mrs. Annenableton taught us how to write an analysis paper in just 45 minutes and how to overcome our fear of public speaking. Mrs. Rasmussen taught us Boyle's Law and how to find the electron configuration of titanium. If you don't know how to do that, it's okay, I still don't know either. And of course, Mr. Henderson taught us all how to properly hiss at one another. Undoubtedly, this knowledge will be valuable as we go forward in life in one way or another. But I think the most important lessons that we have learned over the last 4 years are to always give your best effort, that it is okay to make mistakes, how to build relationships, to take chances, to work hard, and to live in the moment. As we grew and learned, we also created memories along the way. Cesar Pavese once said, "We do not remember days, we remember moments." When I asked my fellow classmates what moments they remember most from high school, many of them said the incredible plays they made in sports, winning speech events, and participating in various other organizations. Others said going to sporting events supporting the Mustangs, school dances, laughing uncontrollably in class, the unbreakable bonds that were made, the simple moments, and of course, what caused our senior year to be shortened, the coronavirus. The class of 2020 is by far one of the most legendary classes to pass through the halls of Raymond Central. We all remember the time when Logan Black stuck a paperclip in an outlet and the room instantly filled with smoke, the time where Mikey McCoy mooned a former teacher, and Isaiah Annenableton, Cole Wayman, and Alan Wola never failing to make any teacher angry. To all of the teachers and administrators of Raymond Central High School, past and present, I commend you all for putting up with this. I'm not quite sure how you did it for 4 years. We have also, unfortunately, encountered more struggles than the average class. We lost out on our time learning, time spent together, our senior prom, our spring activities, our knowingly last day of high school, and all of our other lasts due to the coronavirus. Some of us have also dealt with injuries in sports, loss of loved ones, and our own personal struggles. No matter how hard times got, I think each and every one of us can say that our class was there to support them. A lot of us felt as though graduation would never come as the days, weeks, and years of high school dragged on. But here we are. There will be no more waking up at 6 a.m. every day, going to school for 8 hours, going to practices, and then going home to do more schoolwork, only to repeat the same process the next day. All of the times where we stayed up till 2 a.m. writing that English paper, studying so much for that one test only to fail it the next day, the stress of that 7-day calculus final, running as fast as we can to the lunchroom on Nacho Day, the thrill of that winning touchdown catch, the annoyance of playing Wahoo, the joys of winning that basketball game for the first time in seasons, the celebrations at McDonald's after that big win, excelling in speech, music, and drama, hanging out with all of our school friends, and overall the simple times have all come to a close. As Andy Bernard once said, "I wish there was a way to know you're in the good old days before you've actually left them." To any underclassmen out there listening, take every moment in. Every time you're dreading that 6 a.m. practice, each time you step on that field or court, every day you get to laugh with your classmates, everything. Because soon one day, it will all be gone and you will miss it, no matter what anyone says. Dr. Seuss once said, "You will never know the value of a moment until it becomes a memory." I'd like to take a moment on behalf of myself and my fellow graduates to thank the people that have helped us to get where we are. I personally would like to thank Ms. Bastian for always being there for me and believing in me when I didn't believe in myself, Mr. Spela and Mr. Plucky for having the chillest class environment and being able to relate to all of us, Mrs. Parks for being so creative, extremely kind and understanding, Mrs. Hill for always making me laugh, and every other teacher out there that has pushed us to become better students and individuals. To Dr. Joel, thank you for maintaining a safe learning environment and the occasional snow days, although I think we could have had a lot more this year. To Mrs. Sansbury, thank you for coming into our school district so positively. You are always a friendly face to see, and everything you have done for the betterment of Raymond Central and its students does not go unnoticed. To Miss Osten,
Thank you for supporting each and every one of us and for going above and beyond for us no matter what. And to Mr. Greelier, thank you for supporting us all at our extracurricular activities and dedicating all your time to us. Whether it was letting us throw chalk at a football game in the student section, which was something we never got to do in the past, to supporting us all at our extracurricular activities, to delivering our caps and gowns at all of our houses, the class of 2020 thanks you. The time, support, and dedication you have put into the class of 2020 is unmatched and it will never be forgotten. I would like to thank my parents, Ronnie and Lisa. You have both shown me the value of hard work, taught me to excel to my highest potential, and taught me to never give up. Thank you for everything you did and continue to do for me, whether it was going to all my sporting events or dealing with my grumpy self after a long day of school. I love you both very much. And thank you also goes out to my sister Holly for being my best friend. You have shown me how to be a strong and independent individual, as well as to be kind to everyone that I meet. Finally, to the class of 2020, I'd like to thank you all for 4 incredible years of high school. Packed with memories, laughs, and friendships, I will never forget any of you. Whether our interactions were small or large, I will miss seeing you all. I congratulate each and every one of you on graduating high school and on all of your accomplishments. I would like to give a special thank you to our classmates who are joining the armed forces. Thank you to Tristan LeMay, Caleb Schultz, Richard Grace, and Aaron Orcutt for protecting our great country. I commend you all on what you have done and are going to do in the future for this nation. It is very admirable and your sacrifices do not go unnoticed. I sincerely wish each and every individual in the class of 2020 the absolute best. There is no doubt in my mind that you all will lead a successful life filled with joy and adventure, no matter if you are becoming a doctor, a veterinarian, a teacher, a businessman, or are going to play college athletics. We all have the power to change the world. Don't let anyone tell you different. I will leave you all with this. Dr. Seuss once said, "Your Oftergate places, today is your day, your mountain is waiting, so get on your way." Again, it has been an honor to speak on behalf of the class of 2020 as the valedictorian and class president. Congratulations, class of 2020, we finally did it.
Graduates with a percentage of 94% to 96.99% and graduating with distinction are Kylie Polifka, Claire Wilson, and Isaac White. Graduates with a percentage of 97% and above is Caitlin Comenda.
I would like to thank all my friends, family, and teachers that helped me along the way. It might have been a weird last year, but at least we'll remember it.
Thanks, Raymond Central, staff, family, and friends for helping me get through the high school years.
I feel so honored and blessed to have such great parents and want to express my gratitude for your care and support over the years. Thank you for instilling me with a strong passion for doing everything possible to put me on the path to greatness. I will never forget the important values you have passed down to me. Words cannot describe how important you are to me, so a huge thank you goes out to both of you. Also, I'd like to thank all my coaches, teachers, family members, and friends that have supported me throughout the years. Thank you.
Hi, this is Blake Stanley, class of 2020. I'd like to thank my family and friends for supporting me through the last 13 years of school.
I'd like to thank my family for being supportive and loving, and I'd also like to thank my teachers for pushing me to be a better me. And to my peers, I wish the best of luck to you after high school.
Thank you to my dad, Miss Osten, and my Nana for helping me through all of these years of high school. And thank you to all my classmates for making it a little bit more bearable. Thank you guys.
By saying thank you. Thank you to my parents, my teachers, and my doctors. Everyone talks about high school as being the best or worst time of their life. For me, it was both. The worst time was during my surgeries. I was told I was never gonna be able to wrestle again or live my dream of joining the Army. On December 5th, 2019, I did both. Just because the present seems like your dreams are impossible doesn't mean they're set in stone. In high school, I learned a lot of good things, but the most important was not to dwell on the past, but to work and push during the present to create the future you want. Nothing is impossible as long as you work hard and everything you put in is what you'll get out. Thank you.
My school journey has been a heck of a ride, and especially my senior year. I want to thank my friends, my family, for being there for me every step of the way. It's been a heck of a ride, and I can't wait to have fun the rest of my life.
Thank you to my dad for waking me up every morning so that I wouldn't be late to school, and for making my lunches every day so that I wouldn't starve. Thank you to my mom for never calling me in sick, regardless of me begging her to do so. And in the words of my mom, suck it up, Buttercup. And to my brothers, good luck.
Hi, everybody. I just wanted to say thank you to my parents, all my friends, administrators, and teachers for a great 3 years at Raymond Central. Thanks again, everyone.
I would like to thank my parents, my teachers, and my friends I made at Raymond Central for the past 7 years, and I'm happy to graduate.
I'd like to thank my mom and dad for everything they've done for me.
Thank you to all my teachers and classmates for all the great memories. Congrats and good luck to the class of 2020.
I would like to thank my family for always being there and supporting me through this journey. I would also like to thank my classmates for keeping life interesting and making school a much better experience. And lastly, I would like to thank my teachers for being so supportive and positive role models.
Thank you, Mom and Dad, for letting me exist. And I'd like to thank my siblings for making life at Raymond Central fun. And Grandma Max, shout out to you.
13 years ago, I got out of bed excited to start my RC journey. Just a couple months ago, I got out of bed, shut off the alarm, and grumbled about going to school. Over the last 13 years, I've had a lot of fun, from playing on the playground with friends to frantically finishing assignments 5 minutes before the bell rings. I know that going forward, it's going to be a wild ride, and thanks to my mom and my friends and my dad, I think it'll be okay. But as the years and time continues to pass by, it's time to think like my friend Ryan and spread my wings and fly.
I would like to say thank you to all my friends and family who have helped me come this far on my RC journey. And a special thank you to my teachers, because without you guys, this wouldn't have been possible.
I would like to thank my family, my teachers and peers, and everyone else who has helped me reach this milestone in my life. I look forward to a successful future in college and hope that it'll bring even better things in the years to come.
I'd like to thank the teachers, parents, and staff for their overall dedication towards our success.
Thank you to all those who have supported me and gotten me where I'm supposed to be going. And thank you to my parents who were with me through it all and dealing with all my staffs.
I'd like to thank my parents, my grandparents, and my aunt and uncle Bill Michelle for always supporting me. My sister Holly for always making me laugh. My best friends Hallie Hess and Morgan Potter for all the good times. And Mikey McCoy for always encouraging me and believing in me when I didn't believe in myself. Thank you all.
I want to thank my teachers and my classmates for the last 13 years, and I wish you all happiness and success in your future.
I would like to thank my parents for believing me, supporting me, and inspiring me to chase my dreams. Thank you for preparing me for the real world.
Everyone in our class is a little bit crazy, especially the boys. I had a few favorite teachers. Two of them were Bastion, Nelson, and Smith. Smith was something.
Just like my grad cap says, thank you to my family for always being my number one support system throughout all my years of schooling. I love you guys, and thank you for all that you do. And to my classmates, thank you for always being there for me throughout all my hardships of high school and all my other years of schooling. Class of 2020, can't believe we made it.
To my peers and teachers, I would like to thank you for teaching me so much about myself and so many life lessons. To my parents, I would like to thank you for all the love and support that you've given me throughout my life. Thank you.
I want to thank my teachers and faculty for letting me off these last 2 months. And I also want to thank my parents for having great internet available for me during this pandemic.
Hey, I just want to say a couple things. I just want to say, first year underclassmen, have fun in high school. It flies by. Second is best of luck to my fellow classmates, my seniors. Going to miss you guys a lot. And then thank you to all my coaches, staff, faculty, and administration for everything.
First, I'd like to thank my parents for everything that they've done for me. I'd like to thank all my friends. I'd like to thank my grandma for everything that she's done for me, too. I'd like to thank the boys and my best friend, Caitlin, for always putting a smile on my face.
I would like to thank my mom and my grandpa for getting me up for school even when I didn't want to get up. And I would like to thank them again for trying to help me with my homework, even though they didn't know all of it. And I would also like to thank my brothers for always being there I would also like to thank my older brother for everything that he has done for me. And I miss him a lot. And I would also like to thank Layton for being with me through all of this.
I would like to thank my dad for raising me on his own, getting me through all the hardships and throughout high school. He's been a great role model. My grandparents for always being there to support me. My best friend for getting me through the tough times when I didn't think I could talk to anybody else. He was always there.
I would like to thank my family, teachers, peers, and everyone else who have helped me through this milestone in my life. And I look forward to a successful future in nursing. Class of 2020 strong.
I just wanted to thank my family and friends with all the love and support they have given me with my whole high school career. And it has pushed me to get to where I'm at now. Thank you, and I am proud to be a Raymond Central Mustang.
I just want to say thank you to my parents for helping and supporting me throughout the years. I want to thank my teachers at Raymond Central for helping and encouraging me. And I also want to thank my peers and friends for just being there and all of the experiences and fun times that we've had throughout high school.
Parents, family, friends, staff, Board of Education, and most importantly, our graduates. Welcome to Raymond Central's first ever virtual graduation. We continue to find ourselves in an unprecedented time. Take a moment to think about where we are today. We practice social distancing. We cannot gather in groups larger than 10. We cannot visit a restaurant to sit down and eat. We can't get a haircut, which has zero impact on me. We cannot go to a concert or a movie. And most importantly, we did not get to play the 2020 staff versus senior basketball game. To be honest, seniors, you got lucky as the staff were favored by more than 30 points this year. In all seriousness, COVID-19 got in the way of what a traditional senior year looks like. It has forced all of us to change the way we go about living our lives for the safety of ourselves and those around us. The hardest part of this entire pandemic, in my opinion, is it did not come with a playbook. As like many of you, there have been multiple times where I sit back and think about how much more difficult everything has become. I even started this speech mentioning what we cannot do. When these thoughts enter my mind, I quickly remind myself that the easy way out is to quit or do nothing. Instead, we have to keep pushing forward and focus on what is positive. The word positive has been a focus for myself over the past year as I have read several of John Gordon's books. Moving forward, I want you to always remember that no one creates success alone. John Gordon reminds us we will always be better together, and together we can accomplish great things. As you transition to the next chapter of life, I want to share a few of my favorite John Gordon quotes. Often, the difference between success and failure is belief. Thoughts are magnetic. What we think is what we attract. Every morning you have a choice. Are you going to be a positive thinker or a negative thinker? Positive thinking will energize you. Positive energy and positive people create positive results. There is certainly a lot of negativity in the world, and choosing positive energy helps us deal with the negative people and negative situations that can knock us off course. Finally, I believe Raymond Central has prepared each of you to be successful. My wish is that you bring your positive self to everyday life, because that is the key to happiness and success. You are and always will be part of Mustang Nation. On behalf of the administration, having met the requirements of Raymond Central Public Schools and the Nebraska Department of Education, I present the class of 2020 to the Board of Education to receive your diplomas.
Logan Black, son of Scott and Shannon Black. Logan will be attending the University of Wisconsin-Platteville and majoring in mathematics with an emphasis in actuarial sciences with a double minor in statistics and business. Ethan Boyd, son of Rob and Kim Boyd. Ethan will be attending Southeast Community College and majoring in culinary and hospitality. Maverick Brown, son of Jeff and Tanya Brown. Maverick will be attending Southeast Community College and majoring in welding technology. Zane Campanella, son of Jeremy Campanella and Brandy Campanella. Zane will be attending Universal Technical Institute for Diesel Mechanics. Brandon Caraway, son of James and Georgia Caraway. Brandon will be attending the University of Nebraska-Lincoln and is undecided on his major. Cameron Casey, son of Chad and Nicole Casey. Cameron will be attending Southeast Community College and majoring in business. Isaiah Enevoldson, son of Jeff and Carolyn Enevoldson. Isaiah will be attending the University of Nebraska-Lincoln and majoring in business. Richard Grace, son of Richard Grace. Richard has joined the Army National Guard and will be shipping out July 27th. He will then attend the University of Nebraska-Lincoln. Haley Hine, daughter of Robert and Jill Hine. Haley will be attending the University of Nebraska-Lincoln and majoring in marketing with a minor in business administration. Alexandria Henry, daughter of Josh and Billy Henry. Alexandria will be entering the workforce. Joshua Jackson, son of Daniel and Laura Jackson. Joshua will work on becoming a journeyman electrician. Ryan Jelinek, son of Bernie and Julie Jelinek. Ryan will be attending the University of Nebraska-Lincoln, majoring in electrical engineering. Cassidy Johnson, daughter of Kelly and Tara Johnson. Cassidy will be attending Concordia University and majoring in elementary education. Theodosia Johnson, daughter of James and Tina Johnson. Theodosia will be attending Southeast Community College and majoring in nursing. Miranda Knab, daughter of Brenda Simpson. Miranda will be attending Peru State College, majoring in criminal justice with a minor in art. Caitlin Comenda, daughter of Rodney and Lisa Comenda. Caitlin will be attending the University of Nebraska-Lincoln, majoring in nursing with a minor in Spanish. Tristan LeMay, son of Brad and Alicia LeMay. Tristan has joined the Air Force and will be shipping out July 7th. Colin Long, son of Greg Long and Stacy Long. Colin will be attending the University of Nebraska-Lincoln and is undecided on his major. Kendra Lloyd, daughter of Wesley and Kim Lloyd. Kendra will be attending Southeast Community College and majoring in health sciences. Kendra Mushek, daughter of Glenn and Carrie Mushek and the late Susan Mushek. Kendra will be entering the workforce. Michael McCoy, son of Shane and Danny McCoy. Michael will be attending the University of Nebraska-Lincoln and majoring in business marketing and finance. Aaron Orkett, son of Jay and Patty Orkett. Aaron has joined the Army and will be shipping out July 6th. Jackson Pavey, son of Eric and Cheryl Pavey. Jackson will be attending the University of Nebraska-Lincoln and majoring in computer science. Jordan Peterson, son of Scott and Joni Peterson. Jordan will be attending Southeast Community College and majoring in criminal justice and counseling. Kylie Polifka, daughter of Jerry and Lisa Polifka. Kylie will be attending the University of Nebraska-Westland and majoring in business. Dylan Schweitzer, son of Justin and Alicia Schweitzer. Dylan will be attending Southeast Community College and majoring in computer science and obtaining his real estate license. Caleb Schultz, son of Garrett and Rebecca Schultz. Caleb has joined the Army National Guard and ships out July 6th. He will then be attending the University of Nebraska-Lincoln and majoring in engineering. Blake Stanley, son of Scott and Sherry Stanley. Blake will be attending Southeast Community College Beatrice and majoring in agriculture management. Catherine Sidick, daughter of Corey and Jill Sidick. Catherine will be attending the University of Nebraska-Lincoln and majoring in psychology. Alan Walla, son of Jeff and Stacy Walla. Alan will be attending Southeast Community College, majoring in computer technology. Cole Wayman, son of Dan Wayman and Nicole Green. Cole will be attending Southeast Community College and majoring in ag and heavy equipment diesel. Isaac White, son of Jeff and Chris White. Isaac will be attending Iowa State University, majoring in animal science with a minor in genetics. Clarissa Wilson, daughter of Douglas and Jennifer Wilson. Clarissa will be attending Southeast Community College, majoring in radiologic technology. Brooklyn Yoakum, daughter of Tim Yoakum. Brooklyn will be attending Southeast Community College and majoring in early childhood education.
I now present to you the 53rd graduating class of Raymond Central. Class of 2020, you may now move your tassel from the right to the left. Congratulations!
Hope the days come easy and the moments pass slow, and each road leads you where you wanna go. And if you're faced with a choice and you have to choose, I hope you choose the one that means the most to you. And if one door opens to another door closed, I hope you keep on walking till you find the window. If it's cold outside, show the world the warmth of your smile. But more you live. I hope you always forgive and you never regret, and you help somebody every chance you get. Oh, you find God's grace in every mistake, and always give more than you take. But more than anything, yeah, more than anything, my wish for you is that this life becomes all that you wanted to. Your dreams stay big, your worries stay small. You never need to carry more than you can hold. And while you're out there getting where you're getting to, I hope you know somebody loves you and wants the same things too. Yeah, this is my wish. This life becomes all that you wanted to. Your dreams stay big, your worries stay small. You never need to carry more than you can hold. And while you're out there getting where you're getting to, I hope you know somebody loves you and wants the same things too. Yeah, this is my
always knew this day would come. We'd be standing one by one with our future in our hands. So many dreams, so many plans. Always knew after all these years there'd be laughter, there'd be tears. But never thought I'd walk away with so much joy but so much pain.
Good night, Mustangs. Stay safe.